All right, so AMD has been back lately. Last week, their stock rose some incredible amount. It more than doubled. It made a bunch of people really, really rich. And that's because AMD's Phenom II platform is doing so well. The Dragon platform, as it was so named, is doing incredible. It's maybe not the fastest processor out there, but it scales very well. It has great price point, and it has a lot of value. And it makes a lot of sense to buy them right now. So people are buying them like crazy. And in turn, we have a lot of great Phenom II motherboards. So today, this is the 790GX, this is the G65. This is the mid-range Phenom II board from MSI. Very, very nice board. Great for workstations if you want to have a fast Phenom II quad core. You're trying to hit a specific price point, but you want to do a lot. This also could be a great gaming board. It's really up to you. You're not limited in anything. You have the options to do just about everything. Dual PCI Express slots are on board. Tons and tons and tons of connectivity. I couldn't even begin to tell you. This does support 140-watt processors, which you're not even there yet. Even with the fastest Phenom IIs, you're not there yet. It'll also do the X3s, the X4s, your 920s, your 940s, your 955s, your 710s, your 720s. Even the 955 is only 125 watts. So this is very, very future-proof. This is the SB750 Southbridge chipset right here, and the 790GX chipset up here in the front. So this is handling your hard drive stuff, and this is doing your graphics and everything else. Also, it's HyperTransport 3.0, so it's the new system bus. It's actually a 5200 megatransfer per second system bus, 26 megahertz equivalent. Memory on this thing, look at these slots. First of all, pink and blue, wow. Adding DDR3 to the board makes it really incredible. It's really what makes the Phenom II shine is the faster frequency of the memory. This will hold up to 16 gigabytes of DDR3, 800 megahertz, 1066, 1333, or 1600 megahertz with overclocking if you want, are all gonna be available on this board. Taking a look over here, these are our SATA ports. There are five in total. You have four right here, and you have an additional one right there. They're all hooked up to the SB750, so they will do all the same features, which is RAID 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 5, and just a bunch of disks. Another thing that's really cool about this is look at the insane amount of headers on here, down here at the bottom. You have, what was it? I think it's 12 USBs in total. So there's three headers here, so that's 2, 4, 6, and you have another 8 on the back panel. So that is a lot of USBs. It's more than I believe I even just mentioned. So lots of good stuff. You also have two firewires, which is kind of weird. You don't see that very often, but a lot of headers for connectivity. Taking a look at the back panel, let's go through a little tour of what we got in the back. Starting at the top, you have a multi PS2 there. I don't know how you describe it, but that's a two-way PS2. It can be a keyboard or a mouse. You wouldn't believe me if I told you what that is, but this right here is your SPDIF. I apologize, you will believe me. That is your optical audio out. So that will do up to 8 channels of audio through a toslink cable. It's called an optical SPDIF. You have VGA, you have DVI, and you have HDMI. Now we'll talk about why you have these in a minute. Let's keep going and we'll get into the graphics in a second. USB 2.0 port, like I said, there's a bunch on the back. It's actually 8 in total, right above your HDMI. You have eSATA, more USBs, you got FireWire. This is your Ethernet. Very nice, 10, 100, 1000, obviously. And finally, down here at the bottom, your analog audio. Now, let's talk about audio for a second. Let's see if you can, doubt you can zoom in, but right here, where's my finger? There you go. That is the Realtek Audio 889A. That is a very, very nice chip for audio. 7.1 channel, it has a great signal to noise ratio. I don't remember offhand, I wish I'd researched it. I think it's 109 decibels signal to noise ratio, so that means it's great, great audio. Plus the fact you have the SPDIF or you can use HDMI out makes it that you can have, you know, really nice audio coming out. You also have, this is a VIA chip, that's not what I was talking about. This is your LAN chip for your Ethernet. Now, I told you I'd talk about audio. Let's talk about that a little bit. This actually has integrated graphics. It's the HD3300. It's got 128 megabytes of side port memory. But of course, obviously on top of that, you have two PCI Express graphics card slots. So what can you do with that? Well, it's hybrid crossfire, as you can imagine. You're pretty much gonna use the onboard graphics whenever you're not doing anything that's 3D. And then when you go to 2D stuff and your low power stuff, it's gonna go to the high-end stuff. So it's very simple. And if you don't gonna wanna do any gaming at all, you can literally just use the back panel HDMI or DVI or VGA, it's up to you. You can even do two of them to do a dual monitor setup. But if you do want to do high-end 3D stuff, then you plug your video cards in and you plug the graphics through your video cards. It'll use this or when you want, you go to 3D, it'll use that. That's going to save you power. It's going to help save the environment. It's going to keep your electricity costs down. And it's also not going to heat your room as much when your graphics cards aren't pounding away all the time when you're just looking at your Windows desktop. So that's very important. Now, let's talk a little bit about the rest of the slots, just so you know what you got. You got two PCI. These are the standard PCI slots. These are your two PCI Express X16 slots. They will do X16 natively. And then you have two PCI Express X1 slots, which are also very useful. Now, right next to it, you'll also see the EZOC switch. This is really interesting. These little pins, depending on how you set them up, so right now it's just regular, it's off. But if you do one on, it gives you a 10% increase. If you switch them like that, you get a 15% increase. And if you crank them both on, you get a 20% increase in your front side bus or your HyperTransport 3.0. So those are really convenient on the fly overclocking. Plus, you can still set them up and then use the BIOS on top of that to further tweak. Ironically enough, I read somewhere, I don't know if this is true, I didn't get to plug in the board myself, but I read that they got better results overclocking using this and then overclocking regularly in the BIOS than they did just doing the same settings that this would give you directly in the BIOS. I didn't read how they figured that out or what happens. It could just be a rumor, but if it's true, it's interesting to say the least. Now, besides that, you will take note, you do have some of the, some legacy stuff on here. You do have a IDE cable. I think that's just really absurd. I mean, if you're using IDE, I mean, you're just lost. Also down here at the bottom, this is the real kicker, the floppy. Floppy, there's no point for that anymore. I mean, it needs to go. So that's pretty much it. This is a great board, ladies and gentlemen. It's really, really good if you just need a basic quad-core system. You want a quad-core, you're doing some multitasking, and you want good stuff. You don't want to pay crazy for Intel stuff. You want to go AMD, you want to get that extreme performance at the right price, and you want to save power, maybe use integrated graphics, or maybe in the future upgrade to a graphics card or use two and making it a gaming system. So this is the G65. There is the G70, is a little higher. There's also lower ones. MSI did go ahead and change their naming system, so you are going to notice there's no more of that platinum, gold, diamond. People, you know, it's not a rap video, they got over it. They moved on, and now it is giving you the number. So G65 is middle, G70 is top, G80, and they're going to keep going up. So great board, great value. If you have any questions on it, feel free to email me, and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on the MSI 790GX-G65 motherboard, type in M452-6061 into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, I'm Albert. We'll be right back.